Resolution 10-09-49, authorizing contract for insurance brokerage and risk advisory services. Mr. Gentleman?
Yes, Mr. Board President, members of the board, this is in relation to a new RFP for these services. We have traditionally had these sort of services provided to the district. This is a change in contractor, but it results from a competitive RFP process. I think the interesting thing for you is, again, that you certainly know this, is that TriMet is, the operation of the system has certain risks associated with it. And we have a combination of self-insurance program and purchase insurance that cover that risk and protect us financially. And also, very often, involves third-party protections as well. So, with that, I would certainly be offered to answer any questions you might have. We use the broker both to place the insurance and find the best priced insurance for us in the insurance market, as well as to do regular reviews of our insurance and these balance points to be placed between self-insurance and commercial insurance purchasing, and sort of making sure that we're hitting that balance point at the right point. And so that obviously changes with the pricing of commercial insurance and other changes in the market as well over time. So it's important to keep current and continually review these insurance policies. So with that, I recommend your adoption.
Okay. Questions of the general manager?
So moved.
Second.
So moved and seconded. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed?
Motion carried. Resolution 10-09-50, authorizing a contract with Cummings Northwest for the purchase of replacement bus engines. Mr. General Manager.
Just by way of background, we thought that this would be just an interesting point to the board. Our vehicles are generally have new engines placed in them once, maybe twice. Generally, before a vehicle is retired, they'll have over about a million miles on them. This is the bus. And so that translates to every 350 to 400,000 miles, they go through repowering with a new engine. And of course, what we do is we trade out the old engine for the new engine. A rebuilt engine needs to be the same, if you will, manufacturer, so that there's compatibility associated with that. And overwhelmingly, the transit industry uses Cummins engines, they are noted here. Matter of fact, all but, I think it's 25 of our buses are powered by these same Cummins engines. So there's a level of sort of compatibility and standardization that is associated with that. And actually, in terms of new buses, just about all, I believe all suppliers are now using the same engine as well. And some of the other suppliers over time have pulled out of the market. Again, it's important, I think, for you to recognize that the buses do go through these repowering series of times, every 7 to 8 years. That it's an important part of maintaining the reliability of the fleet, and I think the mechanics do an excellent job of that. They have a very talented group of mechanics. And so with that, I'd be happy to answer any questions. Obviously, contracted by its nature, a sole source contract, because again, the Cummins Northwest is the only provider of the compatible engines.
Question?
Second.
Moved and seconded. All those in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. Resolution 10-09-51, authorizing amendments to intergovernmental agreements with the City of Portland, providing funding, personnel, and other services for Portland streetcar operations. Mr. Chairman.
This is essentially a continuation agreement at this point in time. As many of you know, we are currently providing this level of operation assistance to the Portland streetcar, and it would essentially continue that service through the point in time when there is, I think, another transition point, which is the opening of the streetcar loop, which will be in 2012. And so at that point in time, and actually we're beginning to work on this with city and streetcar staff, we would be coming to the board with a sort of, if you will, a major revision to the overall agreement. But at this point in time, it seemed appropriate to just extend the current agreement until we're ready to deal with that next inflection point and the addition of additional streetcar services. Beth Hamill can certainly answer more detailed questions about the contents of the agreement, but again, the intention is to keep it sort of on a straight and level playing field until we hit that next major point of service increase. So with that, I'd be happy to answer any questions.
Other questions? If there are none, Ms. Ford.
Yeah, the streetcar runner, obviously, that's going to go over to the new bridge, right?
It will eventually. Now, the initial service plan, when they open the loop, will be from the Pearl District, essentially, yeah, one way down to Omsley and then back again. And ultimately, yeah, when we complete the bridge, that will be the bridge.
Is there a motion for adoption?
Second.
It's been moved and seconded. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries.